Simba and Zazu were on their way to the gorge. He saw Timon and Pumbaa along with the cubs. They were running up to safety. Belle, however, slipped and fell down the gorge. Simba sees what's going to happen, and he didn't want anything bad to happen to his granddaughter. Timon, Pumbaa, you both take Zubri and Johari home. I'll be there with Belle, Simba ordered as he ran down the gorge to save Belle.
No, please, Belle whispered in fear as the hunters got a cage for Belle.
Just as Belle thought she was done for, Simba jumped out in front of his granddaughter and roared at the hunter. He had his protective mode on. One of the hunters ran away with the cage, while the other one grabbed his hunting rifle and shot Simba. Belle looked in horror to see that Simba was shot in the shoulder. He groaned in pain as the hunter looked up from the gorge. He saw Nala, Kiara, Kovu, and Vitani were all there. Seeing that he couldn't take out all the lions at once, the hunter took his gun and ran off into the distance. Belle looked to see Simba, who fell on his side. He was dying from his injuries and exhaustion, pretty much. Belle walked up to her grandfather, hoping that everything would be okay.
Grandpa? Belle asked. Are you okay?
Belle had tears running down her face. Simba's family rushed down to the gorge as well as their friends.
Grandpa, get up!
Belle pleaded. As Simba tried to get up, due to the fact that he was shot, he collapsed.
I can't get up. Simba groaned. Simba, you can fight this. Just get up.
Nala pleaded, but Simba was too old and he was injured as well.
Daddy, no.
Kiara began to have tears in her eyes.
Don't do this, please.
Simba, we need you. Kovu added as Simba looked up at his family and his friends.
I'm afraid my time has come.
I need you all to carry on the circle of life, Simba said weakly.
Kovu, I want you to take over the throne as king.
And Kiara, please take your mother's place as queen, Simba added.
We will, Daddy. We'll do it for you, Kiara sobbed.
Simba, please don't do this, Nala cried as tears started to stroll down her face.
I can't lose you. Not like when Scar was ruling.
I'm afraid not, Kiara.
Or Nala.
Things don't always end with a happy ending, Simba replied to his mate.
Grandpa, why?
Belle asked with tears rolled down her as Simba looked up at his granddaughter.
Belle, I need you to stay strong, not only for your family, but for me as well, Simba replied with a raspy voice.
I'll miss you, Grandpa, and so will your friends and family, Belle sobbed.
Simba, just fight it, Timon encouraged Simba. You can't leave us.
Yeah, you just can't.
Pumbaa added, I'm sorry, you guys, but it's ending like this. Simba coughed.
Just do me a favor. Look after Belle. I know she'll be queen someday, and Kovu will take over the throne. I love you all. Look for me in the sky.
Simba replied with taking his last breath. He closed his eyes and passed away. Nala, along with her family and friends, began to cry. Losing an old king who once ruled the Pride Lands was heartbreaking. They lost a friend, a father, a grandfather, a mate, and a king. Kovu decided to arrange a funeral for Simba to pay respects to him. They all returned to the Pride Rock to gather around for a funeral. All the lionesses, along with the cubs, Zazu, Rafiki, the Lion Guard, Timon, and Pumbaa, Kovu gathered them around Pride Rock at night. He got everyone's attention for the funeral of Simba.
Thank you all for joining us tonight here at Pride Rock, Kovu began.
Tonight, we all say goodbye to another great king. Simba has sadly departed from us. He sacrificed himself to save my daughter, Belle. Belle sobbed into her mother's side as Kiara cried as well. Everyone was sad to hear about Simba's passing. Simba was more than just a king. He was a loving father, a grandfather, a mate, a friend, Kovu continued. He did his best to hold back his tears. He ruled the Pride Lands for many years, and he will deeply be missed. So it is with our heavy hearts that Kiara and I presume the throne. Kovu began and soon broke down into tears, then Kiara spoke up. Goodbye to Simba, who was once a son to Mufasa and Sarabi, a father to me and a great king who protect us, Kiara added. A few days after Simba's passing, Nala was still feeling the pain of losing her mate she once loved. Kiara noticed her
Mother, still feeling depressed, everyone in the Pride Lands were trying to move on as well. "Mother?" Kiara asked. "Are you okay?"
"I'm fine, Kiara. I'm just still sad that we lost your grandfather,"
Nyla replied as she and Kiara both shared an embrace together.
"We'll get through this together. I know times are going to be hard right now," Kiara said. "Kovu is doing great as king so far."
"Yeah, those hunters who were around the cubs could be captured
by them," Nala replied with fear in her voice.
"We might just be able to locate where the humans are. I bet they have a camp somewhere,"
Vitani cuts in on Kiara and Nala.
You think you know where the camps are?" Nala asked Vitani.
"I'll take a look around, and if I do see a camp, I'll warn you all," Vitani replied.
"Don't get caught," Kovu said as Vitani ran off in search of the humans in their camp. Vitani was far away from Pride Rock when she looked around the Pride Lands in search of humans. She did, however, smell smoke in the distance, so she followed the smell of the smoke. However, she did have to watch her step in case if she triggers a trap or something. Once Vitani followed the smell of the smoke, she saw that there was a human camp in the distance. She could see animals in cages and even some were being shipped in crates. They wanted to capture Belle.
"I can't let any of these people hurt my family," Vitani said as she saw a few humans taking the animals out of their cages.
Meanwhile, back at Pride Rock, Kiara was putting her daughter down for a nap when Vitani returned. She was unharmed from her trip, which she considered it a good thing. "So," Kovu began as he saw Vitani returned, "did you locate where the humans are?"
"Yes, I did, and they have animals in cages as well as a truck," Vitani replied.
"We'll have to take down the camp somehow, or make them leave us alone," Kovu said as he paced around Pride Rock. "If Simba was alive, he'd know what to do. Simba sacrificed himself for his daughter, for our daughter, Kiara said to Kovu. He would have said to start a stampede there, or set the camp on fire."
"We'll just have to leave the camp and the humans alone," Banu suggested.
"Now, I'm not saying we should do this in violence. I'm just suggesting so no one gets hurt."
"They might come after us, even if we leave them alone," Kiara replied.
"We'll attack then, but only to protect the cubs," Nala said.
"Belle, along with Zubri and Johari, were off to play."
"I'll go with them, just in case if anything happens," Vitani said.
"Vitani, just be careful," Kovu replied to his sister.
"I will, Kovu. Keep the Pride Lands safe," Vitani told Kovu as she ran off with Belle, Johari, and Zubri.
When Vitani and the cubs were playing around the Pride Lands, Vitani kept her eyes on the cubs. She didn't want any of the cubs to get hurt, especially if Scarlet returns or the hunters show up. Belle, along with Johari and Zubri, were all playing around the Pride Lands. Vitani laid her eyes at least a few feet away from the cubs.
She was on watch for hunters, and she looked up to see that there was no hunters close by.
Suddenly, Belle heard a cry for help, and she looked to see a human boy. He was stuck under a fallen log.
"Vitani, someone needs help!" Belle cried out.
Vitani rushed towards Belle and her friends, and saw the human boy stuck under the fallen log. Johari and Zubri, along with Belle, saw that Vitani rushed over, and she saw the human boy was younger.
"What's going on?" Vitani asked to see a human stuck under the log.
"He's not going to hurt us, is he?"
"No, I won't hurt any of you," the human boy said as he struggled to get free from the log.
"Let's help him, cubs. Push with me," Vitani said as he, along with Belle and her friends, all pushed the log together. With a few pushes, the boy was free.
"Thank you so much," the boy said as he petted Vitani. "You're a pretty lion. I wonder if there's any more of you."
Then the boy looked down to see three cubs playing.
"You must be the cubs. I think I've seen you guys before."
The boy then remembered that his father killed the king of the Pride Lands. And he saw Belle, who was Simba's granddaughter.
"You must be the one Papa was going to capture. But I'm not going to let that happen to any of you,"
the boy replied as the boy played with the cubs, as well as Vitani smiled.
"Maybe humans aren't always bad," Vitani thought to herself. "Those are just good, just make bad choices.
"My name is Hector. I'm with my family at a camp," the boy said to the lion cubs.
"But I should tell Kiara and Kovu about this boy, so that way, if the cubs are in danger by the hunters, Hector will know what to do," Vitani said to herself.
if my papa or any hunters try to capture you guys, I'll stop them. Hector said as he petted Belle and Zubri. Later on that night, Vitani was talking to Nala, Kiara, and Kovu about Hector. Belle was supposed to be in bed, but she, however, was listening to the grown-ups' conversation. She heard some things about Hector. So Hector was the boy you saved? Kovu asked. Yep, it's true. Belle, along with her friends, were with me. And he was one of the hunter's son. Vitani replied, leaving Kiara and Kovu along with Nala in shock.
He might lead you into a trap. That hunter killed Simba, Kovu said. He could be a threat to us, Kiara added.
He didn't seem like a threat. He's just saying he'll try to stop the hunters if they try to hunt us down, Vitani replied.
Did he say that?
Nala asked.
Yes, I heard him say that while he was playing with the cubs, Vitani said.
Very well. We'll see who the boy is, Kiara replied.
The hunters have kidnapped animals there, so there has to be a way to free them, Nala said to her daughter and son-in-law.
We'll have to rescue them somehow without getting caught, Kovu replied.
We'll do something about that when the time comes, but we'll do that if the hunters are on to us.
A few months went by, and Belle, and along with Zubri and Johari, have all grown up to be adolescents. Since they were almost fully grown at this age, Belle and Johari were going to do their first hunt with Kiara and Banu, as Nala was getting quite old for her age to go. And on top of that, Vitani, being the leader of the Lion Guard, had to keep the Pride Lands safe from danger.
It's like just yesterday, my little girl is all grown up, Kovu said as he nudges Kiara.
She'll always be your little girl no matter what, Kovu, Kiara replied as Kovu turned to see Zubri. He started to have mane around him, although it was clearly visible. He won't have a full mane until he was at least between 2 to 3 years old.
You ready to go on a patrol with me? Kovu asked Zubri.
You bet I am, Kovu, Zubri said excitedly.
Are you two ready to go on a hunt? Banu asked Belle and Johari.
We sure are, right, Mom?
Belle asked Kiara.
That's right, sweetie. You're growing up so fast.
Belle and Kiara both nuzzled each other. Zazu was happy that the lion cubs have now grown up to be teenagers.
It was like just yesterday, these cubs are growing fast, Zazu said to Kovu.
Yeah, I just wish Simba was there to see them, Kovu replied as Timon and Pumbaa were slowly approaching the lions. They were starting to get old as well.
As what happens in the circle of life, animals do get older as they age.
Man, Simba would have been proud of his granddaughter, Timon said.
Kiara, along with Banu, Johari, and Belle were leaving for their first hunt.
See you later, Kovu, Kiara said with a wink.
Good luck, Kiara. And Belle and Johari, Kovu called out to his daughter and his adoptive niece. Go get them. Kovu replied with a smile on his face. Once his daughter and adoptive niece left with Banu and Kiara to go hunting, he turned to Zubri.
Ready to head out on a patrol? Kovu asked Zubri.
Yeah, I am, Zubri said nervously. Let's go.